Thank you, Epidemic Sound, for sponsoring this video. So I'm going to show you the easiest way to go ahead and add background music to your streams. You truly can't live without music in your content because it keeps people entertained. So the easiest way to do this is to go ahead and open up your Streamlabs. If you don't have Streamlabs Desktop installed, I'll put a link in the description of this video. So you want to come to Starting Soon, and that's the scene that I'm going to add the music to. And then, of course, you can add it to all the other scenes once you know how to do it the first time. So we'll come here to where it says Sources. We'll go ahead and select Media File, and we'll go ahead and select Add Source. You then want to select Add a New Source instead, and then we'll name this Music Playlist. And then you want to go ahead and hit select Add Source. Now, this is going to go ahead and ask you to go ahead and locate the file on your computer for your music. So you can use any music that you want to utilize. I prefer to do it this way simply because it's not going to put strain on my computer or the CPU or make my stream lag by bringing in having tabs open or windows open or the browsers that I'm bringing in. The less thing my computer has to worry about when I'm streaming, the better it's going to be for the quality of my stream. So this is why I upload my own personal music. And to be able to get that, I utilize Epidemic Sounds. Now, the reason why I use Epidemic Sounds is one, because I'm a content creator, and as a content creator, you want to make sure that the music you're utilizing is not copyrighted. So utilizing Epidemic Sounds, you don't have to worry about copyright music. You don't have to worry about your streams getting muted. You can utilize this, and the music that has here, they have tons of genre, right? Pop, jazz, moods, themes. You could even get sound effects for your stream, for alerts, and just so much, right? And the beautiful thing about Epidemic Sounds, like I said, is that you're going to be protected when you utilize this music across other platforms, right? So beyond just your stream, if I want to use it on YouTube, if I want to use it on TikTok, on Facebook, on Twitch, on my website, on Instagram, that means that when I'm streaming and I'm utilizing music, I don't have to worry about when I go clip the stream and posting it on TikTok or other social platforms that I'm going to get a copyright strike or that my video is going to get deleted because of the music that I'm utilizing. So this is why I invest in Epidemic Sounds. And then I'll put a link in the description of this video. You'll get a 30-day free trial. I even went ahead and created a playlist for you that you can go ahead and utilize in your stream that's going to give you 3 hours of music to be able to play in your stream. So what we want to do here is once you go ahead and created your account inside of Epidemic Sounds, we're going to want to go ahead and download a song. So I'm just going to download 2 songs. You can download as many songs as you want to be able to add into this playlist, right? So to download it, you want to click this little icon here, and then it's going to ask you to download the full mix and file format. For the file format, you can select MP3 for this example, and then hit download. Download, and you could use that for all the songs. Once you have those songs downloaded, we're going to use a tool to take all the songs and make it into one file. That way in Streamlabs, it's just one file that we upload with the actual music. So you're going to come to Audacity, and I'll put a link in the description for this tool. It's completely free, and then you download it based on the software that you have, whether that be Windows or Mac. So once you have that downloaded, we're going to go ahead and get it opened up here. And what we're going to want to do is we're going to come to File, and we're going to select Import, and we're going to import an audio file. So what I'm going to do here is that I'm going to go ahead and open up the file that I went ahead and downloaded from Epidemic Sound. So I have here Stream Music, and I have here 2 files. I'm just going to copy both, and I'm going to select Open. And then you would do this for as many musics that you have. Right now, this is going to be a little bit tedious in the beginning, but remember, you only have to do this once, because inside of Streamlabs, we can go ahead and set it to loop. That way the music just keeps playing. So all you simply want to do is we want to go ahead and grab this song, and we want to bring it here to the end, and all you want to do is drag the song and put it on the same size as this, right? Then we'll exit this out. So you would just do this over and over again for all the music that you went ahead and downloaded from Epidemic Sounds. Once we have all the music labeled out, we want to come to File, we want to select Export, and you want to make sure you export as an MP3. So once we do that, we'll save this and say Stream Music. Just so we know, we'll leave it on our desktop, and then we'll hit save. You'll hit okay, and now that's been saved on our computer. So you'll see here that I'll let you know that it's downloading. Now we want to come back here to Streamlabs, and now where it says locate file, we want to go ahead and hit browse, and that's going to allow us to be able to search. Now again, you can do individual songs, but the way that I'm teaching you how to do it, this is going to allow you to have playlists, right? So here's going to be the playlist that we went ahead and created. It's only 4 minutes, but again, you can add as much as you want. Typically 10 to 15 songs, sometimes even 5. You can just loop it over and over again, but again, it's just based on your personal preference. There's no limit limit on how many songs you can download for Epidemic Sounds. So I'm going to select loop so that it plays. Now you can see here on the right that music playlist is playing. So the music is playing for me, but I'm going to show you how you're able to hear the music yourself and have your stream hear it as well. So we'll hit close. We'll come here to where it says music playlist, and we'll just go ahead and lower this here for the time being. So we'll bring this down some. I'm going to hit this little gear icon. I'm going to select properties. And then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to come now, the general rule of thumb of where I like to keep the music in the background so that it doesn't overpower me or my stream or my game is I like to keep it at about 20 to 25, right? So you can kind of gauge it and see what works best for you. But this is the important feature right here, audio monitoring, monitoring off, right? So you can see the music's moving, but why can't I hear the music? So you want to make sure you have monitor and output. What that means is that you can hear the music and your stream can hear the music as well, right? So you can hear the music playing in the background. And the beautiful thing is I don't have to worry about this music playing on my video right now because I am protected from the copyright. So again, now we have that added. So what I want to show you here is how you go ahead and add that to every single scene that you want to. You don't need to recreate this over and over again. So you simply will come here to the countdown timer scene or the scene that you want to add. You'll hit this little plus icon. We'll select media file, add source, and now here you just need to scroll down. You'll see music playlist, and now I can add that source, and you'll see here that the music will also start playing here as well once I go ahead and unmute it. But adding music alone is not going to be the only thing you want to include in your stream to make it more entertaining, more exciting, and getting viewers to keep coming back. You want your stream to look professional, so go ahead and watch this video right here where I show you how to go ahead and add overlays to your stream to make it look professional. I'll see you guys in the next video.